reasons not to make a scene. And if somebody did a scene, so what is there to do afterwards? So first of all, the Zohar starts with the principle that the whole creation is used like witnesses for what human beings are doing in this world to give their testimonial to Hashem.
Right, exactly. So even like the sheets will give their accounting.
Everything.
Yeah,
so let's see the Zohar. פתח ואמר כי אבן מקיר תזעק וקפיס מעץ יעננה. Okay, there is the pasuk in Habakkuk that a stone from the wall will shout and a piece of wood will answer it. Okay, so the simple understanding of the pasuk without going into like deeper stuff is that the what we understand as stones, wood, you know, different things that doesn't have intelligence and doesn't have capability to communicate, according to the Zohar, actually they have. Mm. Yeah? Mm. The stones, the woods, everything, all the creation have certain way to communicate with one with another, with us, and more of all, with Hashem, that is the creator of everything, right? Says the Zohar, "Kama idle lebarnash liizdaar mechuvui de lo yechta kame kudsh brichu." How much a person have to be careful not to make sins in front of God. Ve'i yema manya said, "So a person can say, but no one sees me, right? Today it's all about privacy. Everybody want to have their privacy. Why? Because they don't want anyone to see what they're doing. Shem yirache. So people think that no one sees me." I have my privacy, so I'm safe. I can do whatever I want. Says the Zohar, the stones and the woods and all the things that is around the person, whatever it is, you're always located somewhere, whatever you do. So wherever you go, there's all the time, there's witnesses all around you. As manin kud shebrichu avid beshlichuta. Hashem is using those different parts of the creation as his messengers to be like spies on all what the person is doing. Ta'chazi, chutra de Aaron, iu ha yevesha el kud shebrichu shirute nasin avad be, trin shlichute beitavidu. So the Gezor is giving us an example how Hashem is taking something that is like a piece of wood, yeah, the stuff of Aaron, that is something that supposedly is not able to do anything except of being a staff, just, you know, crutch, lean on it. So and we see that in the Torah it says that Hashem used the staff of Aaron to do certain things, to do certain miracles, right? And those miracles it was expressing certain quality, certain inner power that is within the different parts of the creation to do more than what we are accustomed to think that they are able to do. Okay? So we look on the different parts of the creation that we know what is the function of a stone, we know what is the function of a piece of wood, we know what is the function of every part, right? A fish, a dog, or whatever it is, right? We know. So it cannot, it borders of what it is supposed to do. It cannot go out of its borders. But the Zohar is telling us, no, for certain purposes, Hashem is taking the same thing and take it out of its box and using it in a different way, as if not according to the rules of nature. But the truth of the matter is that this is the real laws of nature, that everything is bended to the will of Hashem. So all of those rules that we know in the according to science is according to the decision of Hashem. So the Zohar is going to describe about the miracles of the staff of Aaron, how it became to be a snake that swallowed the snakes of the Al worshippers, the witchcrafters of the Egypt, and then it was growing almonds in the time of the argument with Korach, right? All of those different things. So we see that staff went out of its nature to do the will of Hashem. Okay. We definitely can continue here with that article of Zohar, but we're a little short in time. So I want to get to a certain point, which is the truth of the matter is that obviously Hashem doesn't need all of those things. Hashem doesn't need witnesses that will give testimonial about our deeds, right? So why the Zohar is going out of the way to tell us all of what we were just explaining? Because for many people, it's very hard to understand how Hashem is controlling and seeing everything. And it will be easier for them to see what's around them, the physical world that is around them. So I see that there is stones that are around me, woods, whatever it is, books, in my case. So I can see that it's easier for me to imagine them watching me. Yeah. But obviously, even if let's say, theoretically, that if a person would have been like floating in the space with nothing around him, so does it mean that it doesn't have, like, Hashem cannot see him? Obviously, Hashem sees him, everything Hashem sees. Right? Hashem is within everything, is surrounding everything, Hashem is everything. So why we need it? We need it's called koach hatziur, to be able to picture to ourselves, to have the understanding, the grasp of the way that Hashem is watching through everything. All the parts of the creation are part of the whatever you want to call it, the virtual system of the that Hashem is observing the creation, right? The Ashgacha is observe. I think it's the best word. It's not so what I want to say, but yeah, Hashem Ashgiach.
I think witnesses. Is good.
Yeah,
you know,
witnesses. Fine.
They're witnesses too.
Anyhow, point of the matter is, once we understand that Hashem is watching us in every step, and Hashem is with us with whatever we do, so then, what comes to be that when a person makes a sin, so it's like he's doing the sin and he's doing two things wrong. One is the sin, and one that is ignoring Hashem, the presence of Hashem that is with him, while he's doing the sin, and as if I don't see you, yeah, pretending as if I don't. The person says, I don't see Hashem. Right? So that's another sin. The fact that he's ignoring the presence of Hashem, that's another sin. So Hashem, when someone is doing tshuva and wants to do the tikkun for those things, it will mean that he needs to go through those two levels once again, right? So the first thing will be to do the tikkun for the sin, but more of that is to do the tshuva and to recognize Hashem's presence in his life, okay? And that's a very, very big portion of all of this idea of tikkunim that we are explaining about. And Bezrat Hashem, we will go into that in more details. Baruch Adonai Leolam, amen v'amen. Shabbat. 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 Reish Samech Aleph. Baruch Hashem. We are moving. Reish Samech Aleph.